上课。 Alright. So for the rest of the morning and this afternoon, we'll be learning about lesson planning and activities. So this is a very important session concerning concerning like teaching. So but here we have Winnie. Yes. And Winnie works for the Fulbright
program.
Right, so hand it over to Winnie. So let's give her a big hand.
Hi, everyone.
Hello.
Hi. Okay, actually, I can't quite tell who is the foreign teacher and who is the local teacher.
They're all in the middle. The foreign teacher, they sit in the middle.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
And
okay.
They look like Caucasian. Yeah, some they can tell from some look like Caucasian and actually white teacher.
Great, that brings diversity to the classroom, that's awesome. Great, okay, well, so before I start, I would like to talk about the class today. Well, my name is Winnie and I work for Fulbright Taiwan. And before everything starts, I want to say something. English is not my first language. Therefore, when I speak English, I might use a lot of words and phrases, and that makes you confused. Because those words and phrases and sentences might carry my own cultural norm and my own culture connotation, and also my how everybody views politeness in my culture. So if I sound offensive, I might not mean that way. Okay? Even if the tone is like that, I might not mean that way. I definitely do not mean that way. Okay, so if you have any questions, please feel free to ask me anytime and try to clarify your question. I will try to explain myself. I will try. Please, just anytime, ask questions. So today, the plan is, first of all, I would like to do a warm-up activity, find someone who I think you are very familiar with this. And then we're going to talk about some TESOL terminology and do a short methodological review. Okay. Can I ask a question? How many of you know about TESOL? Great! So I might need your help to do this. And then we're going to talk a little bit about communicative teaching, and then I'm going to share with you some experiences and my ideas about English classrooms in Taiwan that give you a realistic idea of who you're going to teach and what challenges you might encounter. Okay. And then we're going to look at the curriculum guidelines, and which might give you some ideas of what is expected in the English classroom. And then, we're not going to talk about this, but similar. And then we're going to do, And then we're going to do lesson plans and some teaching practice. Cool? So, before we start, okay. Different ones, we're going to do textbook analysis. So do we have textbooks here?
Yes.
Do we? Okay. Everybody already look at the textbook? No? Okay, great. And then we're going to do lesson plans and then session reflection. Okay. Now, so talk about me. I was the TEPL advisor last year in Taiwan, 2013 and 2014. So what did I do? I travel around all over Taiwan to different counties and train the ETAs to teach, co-teach in the English classroom, elementary school classroom and junior high school classroom. And who are the ETAs? ETAs, they are America college graduate students who applied for a Fulbright grant. And after they receive this grant, they come over here to serve in the country, in this country. Okay. So I was the director of a bilingual school in New Taipei City. And this year, I'm not continuing my TEFL advisor position because I'm going to start my PhD degree, PhD study in Shida. And then I was in Texas studying MA. Okay. And, yes. Are you serious? Woohoo! Yay! Texas! Okay. And then, crazy, right? And then I got a BA in English and Turkish. So I speak different languages. However, I don't know, I probably only know three phrases in Turkish right now. You know, when you don't use a language, you just don't remember and you forget. The same thing learning English in Taiwan. They don't use anything like that. Okay, so I would like to know everybody a little bit, so I would like everybody to take just 1 minute, introduce yourself to me, your name, where you're from, and why are you here, and something we should know about you, and then why do you want to get out of this workshop? Cool? Do you all know each other very well?
Yeah.
So this is just for me, okay? Just to amuse me. Okay.
It must be a time I really like.
Great! Oolong tea. So did you get something from yesterday's workshop or presentation? I thought that was talking about the educational system. Okay, great. Okay, so Aaron, nice meeting you. Deisha, you know this one, right? Deisha. Aaron. To go there. because of the, you know, mainland China cross strait issues. So yeah, that was my first time. And I've never been to Hong Kong, so I really want to go. But, yeah. Lynn, what number? Huh? Oh my god, I'm illiterate. broaden kind of the perspective and the views. So it's really cool what I learned last year. Possible, if possible, I would like you to share more of what you did in your home country later, and share your ideas and how you would use a certain activities and your ideas, your philosophies, so that we can all benefit from each other. Okay. So anything else? Thank you, Shannon. Nice meeting you.
Thomas.
Okay.
I'm from Texas, USA, and I taught there for 5 years in high school in biology. And why am I here? I'm here.
You taught what?
High school biology.
Whoa, high school. Okay.
Yeah. And I'm here because I pretty much got bored with the U.S. I've been all over the U.S., so, and I've never been across the Pacific. So when I heard the idea of coming to Taiwan, I didn't even know Taiwan was an island.
Thailand,
yeah, I had to look it up. I heard it's Taiwan. Yeah. So, but I'm here. I'm having a good time. Something you should know about me is that I'm very open, and that's really why I came to Taiwan. Is because I don't care. What's out there? It's a great world. You know, that's my biology mind taking effect. It's like, you know, let's go see other parts of the world, you know. And so if I'm outside, I'm kind of dozing out. It's not because I'm a daydreaming. I'm probably looking at the leaves like, wow, why are they growing like that, you know. And, I'm so open. It's because, you know, I've got a science mind, but I love sports. I love music, you know. And but I'm very laid back. I'm very easygoing. What I want to get out of this workshop is, well, you know, I'm a teacher, so any way to improve my teaching ability, ideas, activity ideas, maybe a better way to lesson plan. I'm like a sponge. I soak it all in.
I think I have a lot to learn from. Great.
Cool. Nice meeting you. Thanks for.
My name is John. I'm number 3.
John, okay.
I'm from Cape Town, South Africa. Why am I here? I've been in Taiwan for a couple of years. I've been here for about 7 years. I really want to know what it's like to work in a government school. I want to teach regular kids, just like run-of-the-mill kids.
So prior to this, you were working here? No?
I was working in private schools.
Which one?
I can never pronounce it properly.
Yuzhen, was it? They're very prestigious. They're very school. They're Princeton.
So I just, kind of want to get to teach regular kids. I just want more to run on the mill.
Do you think there will be a difference?
Oh, yeah.
So?
I've been kind of, the last year, I've been working kind of part time for Fongyan Elementary School in Taichung.
Those ADD students, ADHD students.
Yeah, like that's Thomas. I'm just
few years. I decided to retire at the beginning of this school year, but I knew I wasn't retiring from education. I just thought I was going to, you know, work more with my children, to volunteer, do a little bit of work on the side, because I knew my little pension was too little to work on. Before the invite for my retirement, this came through the English department in Taiwan, and I said, why not? So that's why I'm here. I love to travel. I traveled a lot of different places, but there's something more to go to. I like to learn about new cultures, and I believe we're all the same. We just maybe do things a little differently. And I hope to find out maybe some new ways of doing my old things, and probably through learning more about the culture. My family is very important to me. My son, I know I'm not going in order.
It's okay.
I left a visually impaired son at home. He's a man. But I think this will help him to be a little bit more independent also, not having me around. So I'm looking forward to meeting you.
Thank you, Will. Have a great time here. Thank you. And?
My name is Van. I'm number 7.
Okay, thank you.
And I'm from Houston, Texas. So
cool.
Yeah.
A lot of Texas.
It's about me. I was born in Vietnam, but my family were actually so I can speak Chinese, Cantonese, English, and some favorite Chinese.
This is great. Were you here last year?
I did come to orientation. It was actually my third year returning to teaching program.
Wow. So she has a lot to share.
Well, I'm still learning too. That's why I'm here, to get out, because I just want to get more ideas and strategies to improve my teaching. And I'm a travel. I love to travel. That's why I want to get out and see the world and also expand my perspective.
Great. Something I like about this program is that the teachers come from different cultural backgrounds. In the textbook, well, you maybe haven't seen that, but in the textbook, the holidays is all about Christmas and Halloween. But Christmas is not everybody's holiday, and Halloween is not everybody's holiday. So I think this is really good for everybody to contribute a little bit of your background, your culture, into the program. Last year, the ETAs, one of the ETAs had, I think her mom was, I forgot, but half Japanese and half Muslim background. So in the school, she was talking a lot about the Muslim culture and the food and also the music, and it was really eye-opening for the students. So it's not about the American culture or the English culture as a all about like being global. English is a global language, so how do we use this language derived from its own culture, but using it as a tool to communicate? For example, I speak English in a Chinese way, but I am able to communicate with you, but maybe with more like negotiation, right? So I think this is really good. So I believe you have a lot to offer. Vietnamese and Cantonese. Wow, culture. Oh, fun. Thank you.
I'm here, I'd like to talk for 3 years.
learning about how it wants to be and how it's being done, you know, how we're going to choose kids and things in English, but just find myself and what kind of teacher I am. If I'm a first year teacher, I'm not just graduating, so.
Congrats. This is going to be a wonderful year, I believe. Well, okay, rambling time. I personally have been teaching for 15 years, and I love teaching because I think teaching, okay, culture, teaching is like meditation. I don't know whether you believe it or not, but I think teacher is like meditation. Why? Okay, for example, I walk into the classroom and one student cursed at me, sweared at me, and the same thing happened to a different teacher. I got mad. She didn't. Why? Why? The same thing, same situation. Why is that? Something inside must have triggered something. The words must have triggered something. Therefore, I respond to that with my own emotion. So if I go back and think about what is that exactly triggered that emotion, think about it and reflect on that, and everything makes me a better person. And in the classroom, you know a teacher, if you're a homeroom teacher, if you have been a homeroom teacher, you know that in the classroom, there's like a lot of things you need to take care of. The kids are like, teacher, it's not fair, teacher, blah, 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 teacher, I spelled my name, teacher, blah, 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 everything. So, for every single instant, you need to react to that, and every reaction is a kind of instructional decision, because you are deciding on things, and you're reacting to that based on your own, you as a person, right, everything inside. Your education, your family background, your whatever that is inside. So I think teaching is a really good way to know who I am, to know me, like to know exactly what is inside. And you don't have to know about yourself through teaching. Of course, you can go outside, work in the office, or work in the business field. But it's scarier. Why? Because kids are more cleaner. Pure. They don't remember what you have done wrong to them. They forget everything easily. But outside, if you treat someone bad, they will remember forever, and you might get the consequences. So it is a scary world out there, but a better world here for, you know, practice, meditation, kind of thing. That's what I think. Okay, enough rumble. So first of all, I would like everybody to do a little activity just to have fun, okay? So have fun, have fun. So I'm going to give you this sheet. And please write down the name. Ask each other questions. Ask every time. There are 15, 16 questions, so ask different person each time. If you can. I think we have 16 here, so can you play two? So I would like you to stand up, just walk around and interact with people and ask questions. And every single question, please ask a different person, okay? So let's have ask questions, ask questions.
More. Yes,
yes.
vegetarian. Who's not?
Yeah.
Good, well hunting. That was wonderful.
Yep.
Well, is that a good, well, haunted, right? Yeah.
Dead Boys Society. That's my favorite.
Which one?
Dead Boys Society.
Dead Boys Society. I don't know that one.
It's in 1999.
Oh, I don't know.
You must see that.
Okay.
It's a TV movie about teachers.
Oh, really? Oh, I don't know about it.
Come in here.
Who does not like chocolate? Who has a bizarre talent?
Thomas.
Andrew. Oh, is your bizarre talent?
I can make my thumb pop.
That's bizarre. That's bizarre.
I don't know if it's a talent.
What about yours?
I can snap all my fingers.
Snap all the fingers,
huh? Oh, you can do that slim picture or something. Okay, so my question, in what way is this activity culturally event? If you look at the questions here, which ones do you think are culturally embedded? Like it has a cultural connotation in it, meaning that if people from a different country might not know it, say that people from Taiwan might not know it. Okay. For example, some of the questions are designed for Indian students. So you know Indians, they have a lot of kids. They like to have a lot of kids. So is an only child will be like very difficult to find in the classroom.
Oh,
the
cow.
Yes, owns a cow too. In India, a lot of people own cows. So you can see like cows walking on the street, so it's like very normal. So this is a question designed for students to be able to answer. Yes. Okay. What else? It's not from the USA? Good. So if you're doing this in the Taiwanese classroom, the students can only ask one person. Who? You. Maybe, right? And then they probably will find out, oh, you're not from the USA. Okay. So, how can you modify this activity to reflect Taiwanese culture? Now, I would like you to get into a group of three and think about these questions, all of them, and then we can talk about it. Okay? So, how about 1, 2, 3 here? 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2. Four, okay, 3, 3, 4. Okay, and the counselors, you are welcome to join any group, okay? Questions on this, on the slide, not on the paper, on the slide. Think about these questions and then yes, but if you have something else to add, you can.
So, yeah.
I
feel they should know.
Mm-hmm.
And